Right now, we will go over a few instructions for the lab, which will begin at 2 o'clock.
So, the afternoon lab, we had asked everyone to bring a headphone and a mic. So, if every individual is not having a headphone or a mic, it is okay if you do it in pairs or as a group. The essential idea of this lab is to introduce you to the idea of screencast. So, this lab is known as a video creation lab, and we have uploaded this particular PPT in the resources for week 2. You can download this document from this AVU also. So, the focus is on creating video for your own classroom. What you did so far in the previous sessions, features of flipped classroom, benefits, how to construct flipped classroom, out of class videos, in class activities. So, yesterday you did selection of out of class videos. But what you are going to do today is explore technology tools to create videos, specifically screencasts for your own classroom. You are also going to write learning objectives expected from the student after watching the video. Note that these learning objectives are usually at lower cognitive levels. So, if you have watched the revised Bloom's taxonomy videos, then you will be knowing how to write these learning objectives at lower cognitive levels. And at the end of the lab, you are going to create a video or screencast for your own course using this tool. Please note that this video is completely different from the video that you selected yesterday. So, ideally, we want you to select a different topic, not the same one. Because the video, good videos are already available for the topics that you selected yesterday. This is consider a scenario that somebody, so your students have watched this video, you have done a session, and suppose there are some concepts which have not yet been clarified, or there are some additional concepts that needs to be clarified even apart from the video. So, consider a case like that and then start creating this video. So, it could be either a related topic or a completely different topic from what you did yesterday. So, the screencast, what it does, what should this video? So, it is essentially a video. So, this is one example. So, there were, this is a simple example of using recursion. So, again, this is something which is related to computer science engineering. But please, people who are not familiar with the domain, please note what functionalities of the screencast you have used. So, it is only to get an idea, there is some audio narration which explains the topic, there is a continuous slide movement and there are writing on slides. So, they use the pointers. So, for example, if you see, I am using this pointer right now. So, if you record it, this pointer movement is also captured. So, all these things get captured. So, all you have to notice, do not focus too much on the content that is being discussed, but note the various things that this particular video provides you. It is a YouTube video and you can directly watch it from your remote center. So, points to take care while creating video, it is same as what you did for selection of video over here, but you have control. So, keep the length of the video to 5 to 10 minutes. This is because it has been found that shorter videos are more engaging. The previous example, if you look at it, it is a bit long. But since one of the research scholars over here created it for a lengthier self-learning session, there were specific activities, it was chunked and specific activities were given from that. If the topic is too big for a single video, 10 minute video, then split it into 2 videos. If you are presenting animation, since you have using a desktop, when you are presenting the animation, it is better to use audio narration along with it rather than text. So, if there is text and video together, there will be some cognitive load on the learner. So, over there, try to use audio as far as possible and it will make the content acquisition, so the information acquisition much more easier. Now, tools for creating classroom videos, there are several technology tools that can help you create videos. The tools that you can use vary based on operating system of your computer. Some of the common tools, CamStudio, Camstasia, Jing, Screencast-O-Matic, these tools have different features in terms of operation, usage, look and feel and everything. So over here you will be using Screencast-O-Matic and Record My Desktop. So Screencast-O-Matic is for Windows users and Record My Desktop if you are a Linux user. So for Windows users, explore the Screencast-O-Matic tool. It is available for download over here. There is also a video tutorial. So before starting your screencast, do look at the video tutorial that is there. The browser should have the Adobe Flash Player plugin enabled to watch the video. Play with various features in this tool. Create some sample videos, show it to your neighbor. So this is very important. So whatever you create today, just make sure that an internal peer review happens. So even if somebody is from a different domain, you can show it to them and ask opinions about, have you used audio narration correctly? Have you used the pointers correctly? Have you used the features of the tool correctly? All these things you can discuss with your peer regardless of the domain, because essentially it is the same activity that is going to happen. You are going to record a desktop. For Linux users, the Record My Desktop is available at this particular site. There is a video tutorial which uses Record My Desktop. So after recording, so this file has to be converted from OGV format to FLV. You can use this particular command in your Linux command line. So all these yellow slides are the places where you have to fill. So yesterday we had pale yellow. Over here we are using much more, visible yellow, which is your normal yellow. First, you have to write the subject and the topic. Subject meaning the course for which you are creating the screencast. So if you have not done any screencast before, so this is just to asking you whether you have done a screencast or not. If yes, please mention the topic, and if you can provide us the links and also the softwares that you have used, then it would be really helpful. So creating video for your own course, even before you start with video, the first step is that you have to write the learning objectives. The learning objectives should usually at lower cognitive levels. You have to also mention the cognitive, the Bloom's, revised Bloom's cognitive level of each of these learning objective. So creating video for your course, the third step is planning. So you require some amount of planning before you start recording. So list down the main points within the topic that you want to cover. Yesterday we saw something called as key concepts. So similarly over here, you note down the key points that you want to cover within your video. If you want, you can also draw a concept map of the topic. So people who are familiar with the concept map, they can also draw a concept map in this place. Please note that the main points are written so that you can plan your video well. To achieve best results, it is recommended to prepare a detailed script mentioning what you are going to say and when you are going to say it. These are known as visual cues. So when you actually go and record a good screencast, it is very important that you create a script first for yourself and then start recording. Creating supporting materials. So sometimes video alone is not sufficient. You may be providing them with slides or some books, reference books, all those things. So if you are using some of these, so if it is a PPT which is being recorded, do mention the supporting materials that you are going to use along with this particular screencast. Then what you have to do is steps 5 to 8. So a screencast is typically a screencast of a PowerPoint slide. So open the PowerPoint slide which you want to use while explaining the concept, then open the screencast tool and select the screen area accordingly. Start recording, explain the topic orally using the PPT. Once you finish explaining, stop the recording and save the video in your system. Now, uploading the video tutorial, once you do this, you can go to YouTube and upload it, or some file sharing site, let's say even a Dropbox or a Google Drive. That also would be fine enough. But what you have to do is, after you upload and save it, you have to just provide us with the link. Do not upload the video into assignments. Currently, the file sizes that is supported are 2 MB. So most of your videos will not be available. We'll be creating this assignment, creating video for your own classroom under week 2. The due dates for this submission is 22 May, that is next Sunday. So, you have one full week to create the screencast, but make sure that you practice the first creation in the lab today itself. You can then refine and do a submission of a better screencast by the end of this week. So, some of the possible future actions to improve your video. There are a lot of video editing softwares like Windows Movie Maker or OpenShot. You can use them to edit your video. Now, all these are time consuming and you need to have some amount of understanding about the video editing process. So, do this only if you are interested in producing good quality videos. If you just want a normal information transmission, your screen recording along with your narration is good enough. The next steps obviously is to create in-class activity which are at higher cognitive levels. Ensure that students get feedback on their work either from peers or from you. You will be given online assessment in the next weeks to do these activities. So, in the coming 6 weeks, you will be given more activities. So, in fact, the week 4, we will be asking you to integrate your out of class and in class videos and provide the links in the course portfolio wiki. So, linked assignments are coming in the subsequent weeks, but for today's lab, practice screencasting. Practice screencasting, and there will be an assignment which is going to be created. You have to upload your screencast only by May 22nd. So, you have one full week to create a sample screencast. With this, the morning session is coming to end. In the afternoon from 2 to 3:30, please go to the lab, practice the screencasting exercise. See you all at 3:45 for the next interaction.